Hello, I hope that you're doing very well and welcome to today's cryptocurrency technical analysis, where we're going to be diving into the Bitcoin chart and going over the current resistance that Bitcoin is up against and some really important supports to be holding us up if we're to be pushing for higher prices. I also want to be covering the trade that was from Friday's live stream, as well as the trade that I got into last night to bring us up to where we are right now in the Bitcoin chart. So I hope that you thoroughly enjoy this one, ladies and gentlemen. Pay full attention because there's going to be a lot of great trades shared. And without further ado, let's go. So before we go over what we are up against right here in the Bitcoin chart, I want to cover Friday's trade. And then a trade last night. So really quickly, Friday's trade, as you will know, I was long, really simply looking for these highs to be taken. Okay, that was the only objective that I had. And we did in the end get to that. We finally hit that take profit on the long. And it took a little while, but we managed to get there at 10 o'clock on Friday night. Managed to hit that take profit on the long. And then obviously, I just wanted to cover that because that's the one that we were talking about for a good hour and 15 minutes on Friday night's live stream. That was obviously the public live stream for everyone. We can see from that high that was taken out, okay, or these series of highs that were taken out, we made our way all the way back down to around $15,700. Okay. And then from $15,700, we put in this sort of just sideways consolidation range. Okay. You don't want to be really looking for, you definitely don't want to be looking for shorts at the low of your consolidation range. And obviously at the high, you were bumping into this sort of support resistance flipped area. So you just had a sideways range for the whole weekend. For the whole weekend, we just had a sideways range. It was a bit of a slow one. And then out of the slow weekend is where you get a setup that just comes to you. It just comes to you literally. Where we see then on the chart, this is then last night, and I think this was just so nice. The setup that we're presented with, which in my opinion is the whole reason we got the rise out of this. Okay, so pay attention because this happens every week. We had a CCV target. Okay, from the CCV target, basically this gives you an original short, and I was short across all my accounts. From that short, we take it down to target. And that was, you can see, was around this fib. So we're looking at around 15,803. This is on the Bybit exchange. And really simply, I want to show you how this was so perfectly called by myself. You can see here at 22.17, I've taken, it's just hit target, now taken along. As you can see here from the search, that was posted at 22.17. So at 22.17, I have taken a long position. And you can see there the follow-up post at 22.22. I've also closed my shorts as it's hit my target. So really simply what I'm doing here is price has hit the target on my shorts. So I'm closing the shorts and going into longs. And this was a really interesting setup. As you can see from the timestamps, 22.17, 22.22, that was literally while we were at the absolute low. And the risk is obviously massive at this moment in time. But guess what? The biggest risks get the biggest rewards. And it's from a totally valid technical setup. We've got the CCV setup. And we've also just got the fact that we're coming down to a fib. And we've also got the gap, which I want to cover in a second. But this was, well, you can see here the amount of shorts that opened up. And this is why I've put like the death symbol, because we're thinking, right, these shorts are going to get squeezed. You see literally at support things like 2 million, 5 million, 7 million and 5 million opening literally at the very low. So this is where it's so easy for players like myself to fill longs, because you're seeing so many people shorting support. It's like how incredibly dumb must those traders be? They're literally shorting millions upon millions at support. Okay, so really simply, I'm following up from an absolute live in the moment update. There's no hindsight on this. There's no, oh, it might do this, might do this. No, really simply, I've said to my team, I've gone into a long and I've closed my shorts as it's hit the target. CCV setup, you can see other people taking similar entries around that 15,800 level. We see then, you know, the brain dead shorts that are shorting support. Other people also agreeing the long was too easy not to take, sort of thing. So I'm saying I've gone into a long. We'll see how this goes. And this is the new gift that we have. Scared money don't make money. Scared money don't make money. As we know, you cannot make money if you're scared. And this one we'll get to in a second. But this was obviously a brilliant trade. Okay. And then I'll move on to a bit of more of the theory of why we got this. So we saw the amount of shorts that, in my opinion, were going to get wrecked. Because, I mean, who shorts this amount of money at support? If you short this amount of money at support, then the most likelihood, you know, the biggest likelihood is that you get a short squeeze, because it's like, it's just Ryan. I think I wrote my exact post last night. It was like, you know, the stars align. Literally, the stars align and you're just presented with a, you know, you see the stars in your eyes literally as you think, oh my, this is just primed. This is absolutely primed for a short squeeze. On top of that, we obviously bounced off of our fib. On top of that, we also had the Bitcoin gap. Okay, so this is what I want to cover now. The S&P also, you know, so the S&P opened strong. So that was another thing I was asked, you know, the S&P, this is referring to the futures market for the stock market. The futures market for the stocks opened strong. So I think Bitcoin will drag it up. I said, hopefully, because I've compound my long. What we mean by compounding long, it means I've added even bigger into my long position. Because really simply, we had the CME gap here. Okay, so the CME gap, this is a gap that we're going to cover in literally a few minutes. But this is another thing to be aware of, the CME gap, okay? And really simply, what I was saying was, I've placed the stop loss at my entry on the long. I'll let the market decide when I'm asleep. I'll see what I wake up to. Obviously, we've woke up to a very lovely reaction. But what I was saying to everyone was, apart from one account, I was out of all of my short positions, and that is correct with the compound on that long. I am looking for higher after this lovely CCV setup. It was a gem for sure. It absolutely was a gem as we wake up to see this. Ooh. The move all the way up to $16,300. I mean, that is nothing short of perfection. literally, that was longing the absolute low of this move and taking it up to where we are now. And so let me cover why I thought that this was likely at the time. Obviously, we had the ES pushing up strong, but also the Bitcoin gap. So we opened, as you sure saw from my screenshot, we opened with this big gap to the downside. So what does Bitcoin like to do? It likes to fill the gap. So what have we done? We've seen price open down here. We've seen the gap up here. And we've seen it come up. Well, we've literally filled the gap now. Price has made its way up. It's filled the gap. And now we are retracing. So really simply, what is the resistance that you're up against now on the Bitcoin chart? It is the Bitcoin gap. The gap has now been filled. So the buying pressure that you had at the low to fill the gap has now gone. And now you've got traders shorting from the gap fill, thinking, okay, well, it's possible that we've put in a high right now because we have filled the gap. That is now a lot of the buying pressure gone. And now you've got selling pressure coming in. So you've reversed the roles literally overnight. Okay, so overnight you've gone from all the selling pressure to, you know, originally on the open, the selling pressure, converting that into buying pressure when we come back to our normal standard chart. And from that buying pressure, we've seen it come up, filled a gap, possibly put in another high, low, lower high, lower low, possibly the lower high to move down for a lower low. You know, that's absolutely possible here. Obviously, if you're trading the market structure, possibly lower high. But the main thing that I totally feel that this move was off of was the gap fill. And now you've had that gap fill trade out. Okay, and I will also share a little bit of theory on this with you. So what we also had down at these lows, was something known as a three drives pattern, where you see drive one, retracement, drive two, retracement, drive three. After three drives, you expect the retracement. Okay, sorry, the reversal. Drive one, retracement, drive two, retracement, drive three, reversal. And we had everything just line up. We had the three drives, which is obviously a bullish pattern. We had the CCV setup, which was a short trade, which hit target. And then upon hitting target, you saw all of those trap shorts. And I must say, I wrote this last night. I'll show you the post that I made. It was, I was talking about hindsight. You know, this is what I was posting last night. The thing is, I closed the short and longed before any shorts were trapped. It was just the feeling I had. There is zero hindsight on this. Check all the timestamps, all the posts before the rise, and literally at the very low while it was bearish. So what I'm saying is, I was closing my shorts here and going long before the shorts were trapped. So you see what I mean? Before we saw any trapped shorts, I was going long anticipating the short squeeze. I was anticipating that these shorts were going to get wrecked. And what happened was, yeah, they absolutely got wrecked. But you can see the intuition that I had on recognizing that this was going to be the case. You know, of just seeing, right, they're not even trapped yet. That to most people would look really bearish. You know, literally that would be a very bearish look. You're seeing volume getting bigger and bigger and bigger on the decline. And you're seeing a lot of, you know, you're seeing a lot of aggressive selling. To many people, they might view that as really bearish. Whereas I am literally viewing that as, okay, I'm closing my shorts and I'm going into a long. And I think that's kind of counterintuitive to what many people would think. But guess what? Many people don't make money in the markets. So, you know, there you go. Basically, you got to listen to me because I think I even wrote this somewhere. Yeah. When you see me close shorts and go long, you got to act. Like, literally, you got to act because, let's be honest, you just got to act. Here we are now at 16,200. And last thing I want to share before I end the analysis, and this is if you want these little bonus updates, I was also sharing this in the Instagram yesterday, talking about the long position that I had taken. Well, not really talking about it, just showing the long position that I had taken. The little joke here. The PlayStation 5 paid for in 5 minutes. So that was a pretty nice trade. And, you know, obviously, yeah, that trade setup was given to all of the champion members. Closing that short, going into a long, and those are the results. So now I leave you with the theory of, well, I talked through the theory of why I was closing my long here on Friday's live stream, so you can rewatch that. From that, we were obviously left with different possibilities, but in the end, it ends with a swing failure pattern. So you get a bearish swing failure pattern. You take your way down to the lows. You get a rise for resistance. Okay, so really simply support flipping into resistance. From that resistance support flip, we obviously make our way down. And during this down, I'm in short positions. I'm either in short and I'm also in tether across, you know, I have a few different accounts. We make our way down to the low where we get a CCV setup completion. That for me was, you know, a reason, one of a possible reason to look for longs. Upon seeing all of the trapped shorts, or again, this was reading the market before it even happens. It's my 5D chess. It's my thinking ahead of my opponents before they've even had time to react and see the situation. I'm already thinking, I'm already trading, and I'm already taking those longs at the lows. Anticipating, and after seeing this trade play out thousands of times, I'm ready and waiting for the trade before it even happens. So I'm closing my shorts and I'm going into longs at the low. This is a high risk trade, but the highest risk makes the biggest rewards. And, you know, we're saying scared money don't make money. You got to act. When I'm speaking, you got to act, because we make our way back up to fill the gap, to fill the CME futures gap. And now we see it back up at resistance. So I've taught you through the theory of those trades, which were, it's literally impossible to have seen a better long position than that. Okay. And then from here, we have made our way back up. So the resistance currently is the CME gap fill. So your current high, literally your current high is the resistance. That is 16,320. So that's an important level to be aware of. You've got 16,000, let's just say 16,350 is a resistance right now. If you claim that resistance as support, you move up to your last high region, which is obviously 16,400. So to make it really simple, I'm going to say 16,420 is your resistance. If you claim that resistance, then you look to your next level, which is obviously the highs of around 16,500. If you make it through 16,500, and again, this is not via a wick swing failure pattern, it's via a close with strength, then you look to around $17,000. And I still feel it's achievable, but you got to get through those resistances. If you fail to get through those resistances, if this weekly does not hold, then you do have the potential of just being a lower high and you go down for lower levels. Obviously, now you have built up support here. So we know 16,000 psychological support. You got that 16. If you lose the weekly, I think you got 16,000 psychological. If you lose that, then yeah, obviously you're searching down to your lower levels, such as $15,400. But I think I've given you enough of a plan. Or at least I've given you the theory so you can understand why prices moved like it is. You know, I've said it many times. If you can start to understand how I'm taking these trades and even being aware, you know, there's just so much. It's just crazy. The amount of value that I'm giving in this free video is really high. So if you can understand why I took these trades, and you know, a lot of money is being made on these trades, so if you can understand the theory behind that, then you know, you're ahead, you're moving ahead of the competition. Obviously, it's a slow process, you know, to actually understand fully and integrate this and getting that intuition. You know, like I've said many times, it's my experience in the market that lets me react the way that I do, that makes me get ahead of people, whereas many people would be hesitating down at these lows. You know, I'm not even thinking about it, I'm just taking the trade, and that's just because I've done it thousands and thousands of times, you know. So that comes with time and experience, so don't not worry about that. But what I've given you here is the reasons for the closing the long, reasons for short, reason for closing shorts going into long, and reasons for why, you know, this is a sensible place to look for a retracement, because we have closed the CME gap. So that's a really, for me anyway, that's a really important thing to be aware of. So I've given you some levels to the downside to be aware of as support, and some levels to the upside to be aware of as resistance. If you'd like the education behind these trades, so more in-depth professional education, then this is a service that we offer inside of the Contenders and Champions group, where we give the education on these setups, primarily off of this three drives pattern that we had play out last night. That was the last live stream that we covered. And if you'd like to know my swing trading setup, so this is a swing trade setup where I've given the entry, the stop loss, and the take profit for a swing trade. This has been covered in last night's Champions live stream. So if you'd like to know my current swing trade, then this was given in last night's live stream. It's still in play. There's still time to make use of that education. And that was given in last night's Champions live stream. I hope that you've enjoyed this video, ladies and gentlemen. If it has helped you, please give a like down below. That would be thoroughly appreciated. I feel I've shared some good knowledge with you in this video. So I hope that you have a brilliant day. Have a brilliant week ahead. Let's crush these charts. I'm feeling so good, so happy. You know, the Bitcoin charts are just giving us some great setups recently. So I hope that you thoroughly enjoyed this one. Enjoy your week ahead. Enjoy your trades and crush these charts like a true champion trader. Thank you, everybody. Goodbye.